This was created by a man who at that time was the wealthiest man in the United States, Daniel Ludwig, and Daniel Ludwig had decided to use most of his money to create a network of laboratories in which cancer would be studied. A network of laboratories because it's called the Ludwig Institute, but the Ludwig Institute has no building. It has only an office in New York, and it has a network of something like a dozen laboratories situated all over the world. There's one in London, or two in London, actually. There used to be one in Cambridge, which was closed. There's one in, there used to be two in Switzerland. There's only one now. There's one or two now in the United States. There's one in Brazil. There's one or two in Australia. It's a worldwide network. And so becoming acquainted with this organization, I was able to propose the ICP as a site in which they would be able to create a unit, a research unit for the Ludwig Institute. And I was fortunate enough, this proposal was accepted. And so one third of this institute is occupied by the Brussels branch of the Ludwig Institute, which is occupies about 80 investigators and is headed by a man called Thierry Boon, who is a remarkable young man, not so young anymore. He's the same age my eldest son, he's 61. And but I'd known him from the day he was born. He was the son of one of my friends in Louvain. And so I'd known him a long time. So when he decided, rather to the disappointment of his father, to study medicine, the father was a very successful businessman involved with a local brewery, which has become the second largest brewery in the world. Sorry. Thierry Boon automatically, as a student, came to work as a student assistant, the way I did with Bouckaert in the old days, in my lab. He worked mostly with Berthet. But by the time he'd finished his third year in premedical year, he had decided the way I had decided. Maybe he did it before. He didn't want to be a physician, but he wanted to become an investigator. So Berthet and I decided that maybe the best thing for him would be to do a PhD at the Rockefeller. And so we proposed the Thierry Boon as a student. And so this is not a fallout of my American adventure. And he was accepted as a student at Rockefeller. Never worked in my lab. He didn't want to, and I didn't want him to, because there's no need to come to Rockefeller if he's going to work in an environment that was the same as he could find in Belgium. He worked with a man called Norton Zinder, who was a leader in molecular biology. And so Thierry Boon did his PhD work at Rockefeller on a problem that was a problem of molecular biology. After that, he went to work in Paris with François Jacob at the Pasteur Institute, where he started doing some very interesting work, this time dealing not with molecular biology of phage, as he'd done in New York, or Coli, E. coli, he'd worked also on the colicines, but he worked in Jacob's lab on tumor cells that were pluripotent. These were tumor cells that would differentiate into different kinds of cells and are responsible for tumors called teratomas. They're very strange tumors. They will grow hair or teeth or all kinds of different tissues. And his idea at that time was to try and develop a line, a cell line, that would be programmed to become only a single one. So he wanted to study cell differentiation.